Hey, welcome to 100 Mile Drive. In this quick video, I want to talk about four things I'm hoping to see in the new upcoming Mazda MX-5 and four things I hope to never get rid of. You might have seen a video by Mazda Japan official. It's like a 36 minute long video where they talked about the future of Mazda and their electrification. And there they showed a white Mazda, which could be a new upcoming MX-5 or an RX-7. They didn't provide any details. And also there's a Japanese magazine that talked about a refresh coming as soon as this coming November 2023. Nevertheless, here are the four things I would like to see in the upcoming Mazda MX-5. Number one, a wide, taller body so that you can fit taller people in this car. It will give more room to the driver and the passenger, because the way it is now, it is okay, but it feels a little bit cramped. Number two, rework the interior, maybe make a bigger screen, rework the infotainment system as the current one looks very slow, and overall add more cubby storage spaces. That would be nice. Number three is add more power. Maybe make it a 2.5 liter, 240, 250 horsepower, but make sure to keep it naturally aspirated four-cylinder engine. And also maybe think about adding a Mazda Speed MX-5 option with a four-cylinder turbo engine. And number four, for automatic transmission, you gotta add dual clutch transmission. That's right. The only bottleneck I would say is a transmission, you do need a manual transmission, or like I said, you know, if Mazda could add a dual clutch, it would be great. But otherwise, this is the king of a twister roads.
That's right. I mean, think about it. Volkswagen GTI has a dual clutch transmission. Forget about that. Volkswagen Taos SE and SEL trims have a dual clutch transmission, and they don't probably need that. Forget about that. My 2013 Volkswagen CC that is more than 10 years old has a dual clutch transmission. And this car would absolutely benefit from that, being able to shift faster and having even better control. I know. Some of you will say you have to buy this car in a manual transmission, and I'll agree with you, but it does come with automatic. So why don't you give a better transmission? And here are the four things I hope they never change. And number one, keep this car lightweight, even if you increase the body in size, but still keep in mind a lightweight construction, because this is what this car is so well known for. Number two, keeping a naturally aspirated engine is a must. I know there are rumors that they're gonna put mild hybrid in this car, but don't add any turbos, at least in the base trim. Make sure it stays naturally aspirated. And number three, keep manual transmission. Make sure that manual transmission stays and never goes away, because this is what this car is so much fun with. And number four, make sure this car stays a convertible, especially RF, hardtop convertible. There are literally no cars left, especially in this price point, that are hardtop. So this is a must to have for Mazda, and this is what exactly I love it for. So this is it, guys. Let me know what you think in the comments. What are the things you would like to see in the upcoming refresh? Also, make sure to watch my other videos on the channel, reviewing this car, doing a dynamic drive, driving it in the city, highway, and twisty roads. And I'll catch you in the next video.